Have you ever created a shared task list in Excel? Stop doing it and start using Planner. So many of you have requested Planner-related content, so here is the video about Planner best practices. You can create a plan directly in Planner, and it gives you a few templates like business plan, project plan, software template, but that's not a good idea. Just to learn how Planner works, go through those templates that will tell you features of Planner. But do not create a plan in Planner and add members. Why? Because when you have a shared task list, it's not only about managing the task list. You will need to discuss about it. You will have to have meetings about it with the members. You will need files. All that Planner will not manage. So it's better you create a team first. Add the members to team, and then inside teams, click on the plus sign and then say add tasks by Planner and to do. I know it's a very long name. Planner logo is green, but this thing called tasks by Planner and to do is purple, but it's the same thing. Don't worry. So add it as a tab inside teams. Now it'll ask you, do you want to use existing plan or new one? Say new one. Now the default name will be generic. Give it a better name, because later on you will have multiple plans, multiple shared task lists. If all task lists are called tasks, you will get confused. So give it a better name. Now when you add it, it'll add it as a tab in your team's channel. Very good. Now before we go ahead and see how to manage tasks, let me tell you where to add it in teams. I'll take two examples. One is a team called procurement. Another is a team called monthly review. Now in procurement team, for every RFP, I have a different channel, because laptops are procured differently and AI systems are procured differently. Now the task list for each one of them is going to be completely separate. So I'm going to add a separate plan for AI and a separate plan for procurement. Now look at another scenario. I've created a team for a recurring meeting called monthly review. In the monthly meeting, I want to keep track of each meeting, so I've kept separate channel for each month. Now where should I add the task list? Because for monthly review also I have a task list. Now in this case, I'm not going to add a separate task list for each month's meeting. Why? Because tasks which I promised in Jan, I want to follow up in March and say, are they done or not? And this month's meeting, I want to add to the ongoing list of tasks. So in such cases where you're replacing a recurring ongoing activity with teams, add one Planner shared task list in the general channel and keep adding to it. Follow-up becomes easier. So now that you've understood it, let's see inside Planner what is there. Well, Planner is a task list, so the simplest method of using it is just keep adding tasks. But the first thing usually people do is add a task, put a deadline, and assign it to people. Now when you add more tasks, it becomes a flat list. Again, confusing. So in order to demarcate tasks, it's a good idea to categorize them. By default, the category is called to-do, but you should change it, rename it, and add more categories. They are also called buckets. Depending on what you want, you decide how many buckets you want. When you add a new task, it looks so simple that you think, oh, that's all? No, it's not just name of the task, name of the person, and deadline. Once you add a task, click on it again, and now you will get a much bigger dialogue. Now let me show you what all can be added there. So before you go ahead, remember you can also add tasks in Outlook. So what is the difference? When do you use Outlook tasks? When do you use Planner tasks? Well, I have a very popular video for that called Task Management Best Practices. Have a look at that and then you will get complete clarity about exactly which tool to use when. This video is going into details of Planner, but Planner is just one of the tools. You use the right tool in the right place. Are you finding this useful? Then it may be a good time to like, share, and subscribe as well. Now let's see details about what you can add in a single task. Of course, we have already given the task name, but sometimes you have subtasks or a checklist. You can add those as well. You can have multiple items in the checklist, and then there is a very important checkbox there saying show on card. What does it mean? So I've added a checklist. When I close it means just click outside. In the task brief view, should it show the subtask or not? That's called show on card. If you disable it, it'll not show. If you enable it, it becomes much longer. Even if you disable it, how many of the subtasks are done? 0 out of 5, 3 out of 5, that progress is still shown. So that's checklist. By default, we put the due date. But if you have a duration, you can also put a start date. And when you have a start date and end date, there is a view called schedule view, which shows you in a calendar the duration of the task, like a mini Gantt chart. The next one is progress. By default, not started, in progress, complete. No, you cannot customize this, you get only 3. Similarly, you get priorities, 3 priorities to choose from. Many people like to color code things. So for example, this color is approved, this color is pending approval. You can create as many color tags as you want. There are lots of colors to choose from. It's similar to tags in OneNote if you like. There's a video for that also if you love OneNote. Like meetings, we have recurring tasks as well. And exactly like meetings, you have daily, weekly, monthly, yearly, and so on. You can customize it as well. Some tasks may require some explanation, so you can put additional notes. You can even add attachments. And nowadays, using AI, depending on the type of task or the subject or the actual task, it may even find some suggested attachments. And finally, this is a collaborative piece of work. So people may want to put comments. So anybody in the team can also put comments and they'll be added at the bottom. So it's not just simple tasks. There's a lot of stuff going on which you can use when required. Okay, so we have got a task list, we have got buckets. Now what do you do? Well, you want to monitor it. People will update it. People will say, this is done, this is in progress. And then you may want to filter it. Now, how do you filter it? Well, it's a long list, but don't get confused. First part is only time related. And then below, it is by person, by category, and so on. So whatever fields we have talked about, you can filter by them. You can also group. By default, it is grouped on the bucket. But if you want, and very often you do want in a review meeting, what are you going to see? What is started? What is not done? What is yet to be done? What is finished? No, don't do that. Just go to group by progress. That's your Kanban view. No need to manually copy paste or regroup. So look at different filter and group options, and depending on the context, choose the right one for you. For example, if you want to see your task, just filter on your name and say group by progress. By default, these tasks are shown like this. It's called a board view. This is similar to Trello board, but that's not the only view. You can just see it as a simple list, or like we say Outlook tasks, or you can see it as a chart. It draws a chart online, and you can see the graphical view. And finally, you can see it in a calendar, which is called a schedule view. The tasks are shown in calendar form. That's all. Your meetings will not be visible here. Again, depending on the situation, choose the correct view. Now, I told you don't use Excel. Why? This is better. Everyone who has used Excel for a shared task list has always gripped that, oh, Excel doesn't give me reminders. Then I have to keep track, open Excel every day. Why does that happen? Because if you use the wrong tool in the wrong place, how are you going to get the right features? So here, you will get reminders. These kind of reminders come automatically. Now, beyond that, there are some features which are available only when you use this on the browser. So open that drop down and say open website. Now when you go there, click on the 3 dots, and there are lots of options, but 2 of them are important. One is export to Excel. Whenever I show planner, the question I get frequently is, how do I get it in Excel? So export to Excel. And then settings. Those settings you can change only from here, not directly from Teams. And one of the settings is about notifications. So now we have teams. Each team has one or more shared task lists or planner tabs. Very good. Now think about it. What is going to happen in real life? I have 1, 2, 3, so many teams. Each team has a task list. Each task list has multiple tasks. I have this one and this one here, that one and that one there. Now, as a single person, how do I know what are the tasks assigned to me? Isn't that important? I don't want to go individually and filter and copy paste. So what do I do? In Teams, you go to the left side, 3 dots, and there also you will see the same icon called Tasks by Planner. Now you'll get confused. I just added it there. Why is it coming here? So there means in the team. So the context is about that project or that team. When vertical menu, 3 dots, that context is me. So even if the icon is same, just click on it and see what happens. It adds another page, and there is a very powerful feature there called Assign to Me. So what has this done? It has automatically gone across my team's channels, plans, filtered it on my name, combined it into a single list, and it has given to me on a platter. So now you can manage them better. when you use the To-Do app, even on browser or inside Outlook desktop or on mobile, you will see assigned to me there as well. So if you're looking at the To-Do app, the task part is coming from Outlook, that is my work, and assigned to me is coming from different projects. And that is how you use Planner to make your shared task list better. Now, there is another way to add items to Planner. That's called Loop. Loop components have multiple things. It's a shared component. Now, one of the components in Loop is task list. And when you add something to Loop task list, it does appear in Planner and you will see it in assigned to me. In fact, now, just recently, another feature was added in Teams. In a Teams meeting, when you say take notes, it actually uses Loop task list there. So if you add an action point inside meeting, that will also appear assigned to me. So now that assigned to me is going to become really critical for you to look at your work getting assigned to you from all over the place. We have seen Planner in detail, but remember, we have multiple tools available and that can lead to a lot of confusion. Outlook tasks, Loop tasks, OneNote also has tasks and Planner. Which one to use when? Now that is something you must know, otherwise you will end up getting completely confused or end up using the wrong tool in the wrong place. To avoid that, before you leave, have a look at this video, Tasks Best Practices, which puts the correct perspective and tells you which tool to use when and which one not to use when and why. And at the end of it, you'll know exactly how to manage your and your team's work correctly. Make sure you like, share, subscribe, you know the story. That's it for now. See you next time.